Hello and welcome to another episode of Hashtag Ask Jochen. I know it's been a long time since we've been on. It's been just over a month now, but thank you guys for joining us. Jochen has been very, very busy for the past few weeks, and we're really lucky to have him in today. He was just in California, and next week he's off to Florida, so he's been traveling. And he's doing a lot of clinics and horse shows. And so we're really lucky to have him today to speak about the revolutionary PSI panel. We're really excited about today's session. Thank you guys so much for joining us. Please let me know in the chat box where you're tuning in from. And if you have any questions about this topic, we're going to keep it tailored to this topic today. But if you have any questions, feel free to post them in the chat and we'll see how many we can get to today. It is a short session today, just a live stream. So we will get it cracking and moving on right away. So we're just going to click this intro video and welcome Jochen into the session today. Welcome, Jochen.
Hey, Mary Claire, how are you?
I'm great. Great to be on with you again.
Yes, it has been a while.
Huh? So yeah,
it's a lot of new things happen and develop in saddle making, and I'm so grateful to teach at the University of Guelph again. And of course, one advantage is that you also see what is the newest, latest thing they're doing. On the other side, it says, oh my God, there's still so much to do for these poor animals. And one of the extraordinary breakthrough is, of course, what we talked today, the PSI panel. So without further ado, as you said, it's very short session. I'd like to start right away into this.
Sounds great. Take it away.
All right. So as you folks, I'm always looking for answers, and I find the best answers is not from people who have opinion, people who have devoted their life for research and development. And we see that it has gone a long, long time. You can see here in this picture, there is an article from the University of Zurich. And what do we see in this panel? Major pressure in the front here on the saddle, pictured from the bottom, and major pressure in the back. Now that comes for two reasons. Number one, there's still false information that the saddle has to bridge so that the horse, here you see the skeleton in canter, or the back is round. When the horse moves, the saddle will have full contact. But the life and the reality in life is that the horse's back doesn't stay up like a cat when it's hissing, right? The back swings. And everybody of you guys out there who has been through the training scholar knows and understands a horse what has a loose swinging back is a horse what lasts and can achieve the goals we're looking for. So everything what goes up goes down. When it goes down, it sometimes goes also down because of wrong riding or wrong sitting on the horse. So how can we protect these horses? How can we make sure these horses don't get damaged to the part where they have kissing spine and hold themselves? Well, number one is we can learn to read the signs, which is shown by many universities now. One of the forefront was Sue Dyson. You know, she was saying, okay, it's time that we learn the facial expression of the horse. You know, look at the horse. They don't know how to lie. Look at the eyes, the ears, right? And then when you talk and surround yourself, like I did, we want to have people who understand the myofascia, to understand the information highway through what the horse feels is there. And we want to know, we want good full panel contact to distribute the pressure, the weight, to avoid these atrophies back, to avoid the pain line in the back. So some people come up with the gel pad, you ride in it, and after 50 minutes, you take it off. But it's astonishing. It works very well with the Western panels or the Western tree, not so much with an English tree. Why not? Because the English tree has a gullet plate and it's very narrow. Look how wide the bars are on the Western saddle. On the English tree, very narrow bars. And what do we see in the gel pad? Bang, look at that. No contact in the middle. Just like in the university article shown here, you know, from the University of Zurich, too much pressure in the front, too much pressure in the back. We see the same picture, same here with a simple test. Simple because of the way the saddle is designed. So many pads and so many designs or research has shown when the horse has white hair or dry spots, it's always in the front, wrinkled hair, atrophy, white spot in the front or in the back. Okay? Again, one of them is the false fitting philosophy that the saddle needs to bridge for the horse to come up. The second is because of the high pressure in the front, okay, when the pressure of the saddle is high in the front, because that's where we see the white hair, the horse protects his back by making the muscle strong. In vision, you'll be trained as a boxer. So you're now in the ring and you're boxing, okay? And one of the things what all boxers have is an extraordinary strong stomach. Why do they need such a strong stomach muscle? Because when they get hit in their stomach, they tighten their stomach to absorb the fist from the component so their organs don't get damaged. Same with the horse. When they get pressure points, like you see on the left here, front left, front right, back left, back right. That's so strong, the horse doesn't bring the back up. They tighten the back. When the horse's back tighten, they go hollow. When a horse goes hollow, they go on the forehand. Okay. We see sweat patterns, dry in front, dry in back. What else do we need to understand? The pound square inch, hence the PSI panel, needs to be well done. Okay. So we don't see this line here. Okay. This is the nerve we call the cranial nerve 11. It feeds into the trapezius. You can see it outside with it pinches. How can we avoid this extraordinary extrusionary pain to these animals? Okay. So number one, we could listen to veterinarians who write books about the pain-free back. Horses don't need to suffer in silence. You can take measurements of your horse now with the phone, and it's very, very easy understood since 2014 by the University of Scotland that the muscle does not get the oxygen and nutrition what it needs when it exceeds, what's it say here? 4.66 kPa. Kilopascal, in North America, we use the term pound square inch. So how can we increase the pound square inch when we see over and over and over pressure pads where the panels are very narrow, digging in the back? We see over and over computerized saddle pads, pressure in the front, nothing in the middle. I mean, the list goes on and on and on and on. Every time we see the same thing, damage on the shoulder because we have too much pressure on the saddle. So how can we follow this theme of pound square inch? How can we increase this? Well, number one, if we don't, what do they say? If it's over that point, this includes an override extension of the equine spine. In other words, the horse goes hollow, right? Contributes to a soft tissue injury. Now, who wants that? Overriding the dorsal spinous processes, what we know as kissing spine. So we don't want that. So how do we avoid it? In the same old system. We want to distribute the pressure. Is bareback the answer? Should we just ride treeless? No, treeless or bareback or pads like this puts over 20 kPa. So that is absolutely not the answer. We need a saddle what distributes the pressure away from the spine. Check this out. All these nerves down here, okay, these are on the horse right there on the spine. You need to bypass that. Full stop. There is no argumentation. That's what it is. Sure, you could say, oh, my saddle designer or saddle fitter said it can't sit on the shoulder or it can't sit on the ligaments. Of course, these people exist. But stop listening to people who have opinions. Listen to people who have education, who have studied and researched a horse's back. And most of the time, those are the professors or universities or the veterinarians who dedicate their life to help these horses. So if we know from these experts, not who make saddles, the experts who know where the nerves, the ligaments, the nuchal ligament system is, the multifidus muscle, a very sensitive muscle, right? then it really leaves just pink bar what you see in the top left corner. That's where you can put the pressure or the selection of the saddle. So when you look from the top, you don't want it on the spine, on the lumbar, on the shoulder, you want it in that pink bar. Here another vision without the trapezius, that's what we want. We want the pound square inch on that area. Now check this out. Look how big the trees used to be, pound square inch, okay? Now we have the Western saddle, pound square inch. And this is what the University of Zurich says. Now these bars, the rails go so narrow. Check out this here, pound square inch. Where do we see the white hair? Under the gullet plate, in the front and in the back. No white hair on the English saddle, only on treeless saddles or bareback saddles or bareback pads. So a PSI panel, you see the dotted line here increases the pounds per square inch to the sides, not to the front, to the lung meridian point, not to the lumbar area where the horse is absolutely sore, right? The PSI panel has reduced tremendous amount of pressure. How is it being done? Well, if we look at the panel, okay? And this is a computer test here, okay? What makes that so much better than any panel? Now, let me stop sharing my screen so you can see the demos I have here. Okay, so let me start with a normal panel, okay? A normal panel is attached to the front of the saddle and the back of the saddle with a couple of stitches there. Very often when the saddle fitter comes out, they put all these cuts in here and stops it from the side, and the panels are stitched together here. So you have a sock or a tube out of leather, and that's where they make the panels. So when I look at the panel, I can squish the panel like I can squish the sock. Imagine you have a sock on, and with that sock, you run and walk over a soft, soft sand. Okay? You feel the unevenness of the sand. Imagine you run over pebble stones. You feel every stone. What if I tell you, in order not to feel the pebble stone, but you want to have the freedom, the movement in the foot, what if I say there are socks that you can run with socks on pebble stones? You don't feel the stones on your feet. Why do I use socks? Why do I use feet? Because people, they hear things, blah, 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 blah. And they see things, yeah, yeah, yeah. But when they feel something, they can resonate. So when we all have, most of us people have stepped on something pointy, sharp, and we have a lot of nerve endings on the bottom of our feet. So, aha, I remember pain. I remember. We remember pain much more than anything else. So I don't want to have my horse that kind of a pain. And if I have a lot of nerve endings on the bottom of my feet, my horse has a lot of nerve endings on top of his spine. There's one area where not so much nerve endings are, but I want to, what the expert said, distribute my weight over a large surface area. So if I multiply 4-inch wide muscle, 16-inch long, times 2, that gives me 128 approximately square inch of surface. So if I have that whole surface, I want my whole panel to distribute this. Here's the problem. If I have this panel and the tree sits only partially on that panel, in other words, let me put the tree inside so you can visualize what I'm talking about. So here the tree sits inside now, but where does the tree sit? It sits fully in the back of the panel, it sits in the front, but here in the middle, okay, barely touches the panel. Now on some saddles, the middle doesn't even touch the panel. There's actually a space where my thumb comes out here. How can you tell? Let me see, show you, I have one saddle here. Absolutely horrible tree design. They feel good to the rider because it feels super narrow, but it's really narrow. So here we go. Here you have a saddle. Oh, nice wide panels, weight-bearing surface, but it's very deceiving. Why? Because the panel is like a leather sock. It doesn't have anything to distribute the pressure. It's very, very narrow. Also, I can put my hand through here and there's no tree. I can see my thumb, my fingers coming out on the side. Okay, so that tells me, I don't know if this billet is in the way, here we go. That tells me, here's my finger, that tells me that saddle tree doesn't even sit on the horse front to back. It's an optical illusion. How can I say that? We see the University of Zurich, we see more and more tools, computerized saddle pads, gel pads, which show pressure here, nothing here, and pressure here. What makes the PSI panel so much better than anything else on the market right now? That's what this is about. And that's why it's so revolutionary. Why? Because we brought the past back to the future. So let me scan my machine to show you this picture. Okay, so what we have done, just like I showed you before, we brought back the nice white bearing surface with this panel. Now you say, it's still a panel. Okay, so here you go, right? It's still a panel. How can that be so special? It's still super, super soft. Ah, now try to squish it this way. There is absolutely no way you can squish that panel. So what I'm trying to say to you, just like in this drawing here, while the saddle sits in the back, partially in the middle, and then in the front, this is now distributed the weight over the entire area. So here I took the leather off, we just put it on. You can see here's the normal tree, then the PSI panel sits down there. So you can say, wow, that has a much bigger weight bearing surface. Of course, the one or the other person says, oh, that's way too wide between me and my horse. But let's get real. If you sit on the horse, okay, the horse is always wider in the ribs than your hips. Let me say that again. The horse is always wider in the ribs than your hips. So let's say this is your legs, okay? So one leg, here's your knees, this is your hips. And if the horse is as wide as my hand when I go like this, if you go straight on with your legs, that hip is narrower than the horse's rib cage. So when you sit straight down, there's a gap between your horse's back, here where my fingers come through, okay? You kind of see it here, the light. Okay, there's a gap. And that gap gets filled out with the saddle. That way, your leg can fall straight down. The reason why you cannot ride shoulder, hips, and heels with a pliable seat in a bareback pad or treeless saddles or bareback is because your hips cannot and will not, maybe they do, but people can't suffer that pain, pop out, right? So what bareback riders or treeless riders do, they turn their toe out, roll on the butt cheek, and then the thigh is further forward and the leg is farther forward. You will never find shoulder, hips, and heels in a treeless saddle or bareback pad because it's physical impossible. Right? So there's no yet horses who have narrow hips and riders with wider hips than the rib cage. And if that's the case, the rider clearly is too big for the poor horse. My point is, when you sit on the horse, the narrow tree right here in your crotch, you need, but where it touches the horse, down there where it's wider, the rider doesn't feel, okay? Because of the triangle what comes over the horse's back. So with that said, the rider doesn't feel the PSI panel there. They feel as a matter of fact, much closer because we can now make a very narrow, thin panel, very firm because this doesn't crush. Now what makes this so extraordinary is that we have a super soft panel and we have a nice firm edge so it doesn't collapse. I'll give you an example with a tire. A car tire has a strong outside wall. Okay? If it doesn't have that strong outside wall, imagine how the tire would look like when the car sits on top and you put too much air or too little air in it. The whole a shape can't hold. Okay, so we need something what holds shape. That's what the, now when the rider sits down, distributes the pounds per square inch. So only then do I have the ability to distribute the weight properly over the entire horse's back. If I ignore that, I see the high pressure points, which we all try to avoid. Now the PSI panel can be done in any kind of a saddle, can be done in the racing industry, in a hunter jumper. You can have it even in combined with the PCR fitting system, where you can adjust the saddle with the gullet plate and with this unique stirrup bar, which also decreases the pressure. Now imagine you have the PSI panel with the center balance stirrup bar. Check this out. This is your traditional stirrup bar. Where do you think all the pressure is? Where we saw the atrophy, the white hair, the skin shearing, the cartilage damage. What if you convert your saddle to a center stirrup bar with your PSI panel? Not only do you have maximum weight bearing surface, you also take the heavy weight of the rider and support it more in the center. Why is the center so special? Why do I want it there? Well, the spine, right, will fuse if it goes hollow. The horse's back goes hollow. And the horse's spine in the center has vertebrates who are straight. In the front, they all fall back. Okay? They're all falling back, and right there it's straight. So why would I want to stir up what creates more pressure where we already have these big holes? So in conjunction with the PSI panel and in conjunction with the proper stuffing, I think the PSI panel is the future of the panels today, because I can make the panel soft. I can give the saddle the necessary balance through flocking. I also recommend absolutely make sure when you stuff a saddle, stop cutting into here. There's very, very easy way these days. You can open this panel. Let me show you how that looks. There's saddles now where you're a saddle ergonomist. We're trying to stay away from the term saddle fitters, because those are weekend warriors, or we call them people who learn something very fast on the flyby. A saddle ergonomist has to be trained over years. So he can open the panel. Now you see the different wool layers in here. Okay, so that's how he learns how to make out of wool, a very special wool. What is 60% wool, 40% synthetic, that gives you that bounce you're looking for. And then in here, inside, that makes that PSI panel so special. You know, you can fill the saddle, you can add the flocking, you keep it soft, and that way you get maximum weight-bearing surface. And we felt very strong that we talked to you about the PSI panel, because you can convert your saddle, you can decrease the pressure. And I hope that this lecture was informative. And if there's any question, Mary Claire, I open it up now to the last 5 to 7 minutes of questions.
Wonderful. Thank you for that, Jochen. As always, really, really great lecture in an incredibly short amount of time. So we always thought this was a really great topic to cover. And I can't believe we've actually never done an actual lecture about this yet. So this was a great opportunity. We do have one question here. Where does the name binate come from, and what does it mean?
Okay, so when you Google it and says, what does binate mean? We took the saddle as the PSI panel to another level and says, okay, with that PSI panel, we could actually reduce the thickness of the tree itself. And if you make a tree, what is very thick, in two equal parts thickness, that's actually what binate stands for. If you Google that binate, okay, binate stands for born or made with two equal parts. And that's how it's spelled, the binate line. We won the product of the year and one of the largest saddle trade fairs in the world, that was in New Zealand, with this product. And it's just another evolution what's the difference between the binate and the PSI panel. The binate has a lighter tree because we don't need such a thick tree. And that's where the name binate came from.
Wonderful. One last question we have here is, this is fascinating. How can you test for the pounds per square inch and how do you get that information?
Okay, so there is more and more saddle fitters. It's a little bit expensive. So if they do research, I find this tool probably the best where you can, this is a little antenna. And on the saddle pad itself, it's a receiver. And then you can see the pressure and you can, they record the video on the screen. So that comes from Germany. And what I like about this particular product, it measures, here's a close-up. It has A, B, C, D, E, has lots of letters here and numbers. So you know exactly where this field is. This would be probably at C7. Okay, so I like this because this is one of the very few computerized companies what has a wither relief. Many of the cheaper versions are very inaccurate. So I always recommend to find a saddle fitter. All my saddle fitters who I've certified, they have to pass on with this tool their fitting skills. And I like it not because it's expensive, because it's accurate. And yeah, it's a little bit time consuming, but if I do some reading, I want to know exact reading. This is also a very good system. The Port Lewis system comes from Calgary. It doesn't tell you how much pounds per square inch, but if all the gel is pressed away, who cares if it's 5 kPa or 15 kPa or whatever, because you can tell there's way too much pressure in the back. So when the university in Scotland used it, they used top-notch equipment. And as I said, ask your saddle fitters if you want to have that done too. We offer that service, but when we come out, we just need to know that in advance.
Awesome. Okay, I think that is all the questions for today. I want to thank Jochen and thank everybody for joining us today. We will see you next time for another lecture, but we will be skipping the Ask Jochen the Q&A for the month just because Jochen is super swamped, but we want to thank Jochen for being here today with us. Thanks for your time, Jochen.
My pleasure. Take care.
Take care. Thank you.